Good morning, students. Hope all of you are doing good. So today we are going to start with your new chapter of English. So get ready with your English textbook and notebook so that we can start the class. So I'm going to start with the first chapter, which is A Letter to God. Okay, as you can see the screen, so it's your first chapter, A Letter to God. Please follow me as I'm going to explain you paragraph wise. Okay. Okay. The house, the only one in the entire valley, sat on the crest of a low hill. From this height, one could see the river and the field of ripe corn dotted with the flowers that always promised a good harvest. Okay. So in the chapter, we can see that there is a house which is the only house in the entire valley. In the entire valley, there is only a house which is in the crest, you know, the top of a hill. As you can, the word meaning, the in the peak of the hill, there is a house which is in the peak of the hill. From there, you can see the river. You know, from the top of the hill, from the house, you can see down a river and a field of ripe corn. Okay. Corn, you know, the field of where harvesting is done. So there are like the river, and it's all of full of cultivation, which are with flowers, which are like it promised a good health, good harvest, means which is the field good for cultivation. Okay. The only thing the earth needed was a downpour or at least a shower. Throughout the morning, Lanjo, who knew his fields intimately, had done nothing else but see the sky towards the northeast. Okay, so here what we can you know, so while the field is good for harvest, but the field is waiting for rain. There is no rain since ages. So Lanjo, who is the first character of the story, Lanjo, who owned the field, he is waiting for rain for the for harvesting. Okay, so now we are really going to get some water. Woman, the woman who was preparing supper, replied, "Yes, God willing." The older boys were working in the field while the smaller ones were playing near the house until the women came to them all, "Come for dinner." It was the dinner. Okay. So till here, what we know that Lanjo, who is talking to his wife, who is preparing supper, you know, he's preparing dinner or preparing food. Lanjo was talking to his wife and asking her that we can expect water, means are we expecting rain this time. So the woman, who is the wife of Lanjo, she said that yes, if God wills, if God showers, then we will have rain in our field. So so there we can know that there he has kids also. So the elder kids were older and the smaller ones, he have kids. Okay, the boys, some of them were working in the field, who is helping their father working in the field, and the some smaller ones who is playing near the house, and the wife calls for them for food. Okay, because the meal was ready. It was during the meal that, just as Lanjo has predicted, big drops of rain began to fall. In the northeast, huge mountains of clouds could be seen approaching. The air was fresh and sweet. The man went out for no other reason than to have the pleasure of feeling the rain on his body. And when he returned, he exclaimed, "These aren't raindrops falling from the sky. They are new coins. The big drops are 10-cent pieces and little ones are 5. Okay. Now when they're having their meal, when they're having their food, Lanjo could see that there are drops of rain. Lanjo could feel that there is rain because he could see that there are huge mountains which is coming from the northeast area, okay, from the northeast side, and it is like Lanjo had realized it is going to rain. Since the air was fresh, we all know how when it is going to about to get rain, the air, the environment gets cool, it gets fresh, the air is sweet, you know. So the same feeling got Lanjo, and he understood that it's going to be rain, and out of happiness he went outside to feel the rain on his body. And he has compared this rain, the rain drops, the big rain drops, he compared as big drops are 10-cent pieces, you know, coins, 10-cent pieces, and little ones are 5. Okay, the 5 coin and the 10 coin is bigger, 10 coin is bigger than the 5 coin. So that he have compared the rain drops in that way. So with a satisfied expression, he regarded the field of ripe corn with its flowers draped in a curtain of rain. Okay. So he was very satisfied. He regarded the field of ripe corn with its flowers definitely continued. So the field of flowers are draped in a rain. Now, draped, you know, it's like covered. Okay, it's covered. So it's like the rain has covered the flowers. Okay. So, but suddenly a strong wind began to blow, and along with the rain, very large hailstones began to fall. This truly did resemble new silver coins. The boys, exposing themselves to the rain, ran out to collect the frozen pearls. So, since the rain was about to begin only, okay, it was big raindrops and the small raindrops were starting. It was just drizzling. What happened? Not even drizzling. It was that rain has just started to fall. What happened? It was a big strong wind which was seen by Lanjo. A strong wind which had blown the clouds away and the hailstones, you know, big stones starting to fall from the sky. Okay, big ice stones starting to fall from the sky. Okay, and that was compared to silver coins. It was begin to fall from the sky. There was no rain but only hailstones. You know, the big stones of ice are regarded as hailstones. And now that the boys had like went outside to collect some. "It's really getting bad now," exclaimed the man. "I hope it passes quickly." It did not pass quickly. For an hour, the hail rained on the house, the garden, the hillside, the cornfield. Okay, on the whole valley, the field was white as if covered with salt. So there was no rain, but the rain has, when it started to fall, it started, suddenly the strong wind stopped the rain and hailstorm was falling to, was falling in the ground. And all the ground was covered with hailstorms. All the field was covered with stones and all the land was covered with the stones, and it was turned into white. Okay, it looks like salt. Big pieces of salt was covered on the whole field. So there was no rain but the hailstorm. So Rancho was expecting that it should go away quickly as soon as possible. So not a leaf remained on the trees. The corn was totally destroyed. The flowers were gone from the plants. Lencho's soul was filled with sadness. When the storm has passed, he stood in the middle of the field and said to his son. Okay, what he said to his son? We'll talk about it later. So due to the hailstorm, so it's a big stone falling from so up top of the sky. So what happened? It destroyed the trees of the leaves of the trees, and it destroys the Lencho's flowers, the crops, you know. It destroyed everything of Lancho because of the small hit of the hailstorm. So the large, bigger pieces of stones, it destroyed all the field of Lancho. So he was very sad because he was about expecting rain that he could harvest properly. He could grow his crops properly. So there will be, you know, he will have a proper amount of living for his life. He's, because his fields are so, are on his livelihood. Okay. So, but it was no rain, which you're expecting. But instead of rain, he had to face hailstorms. He had to face large pieces of stones falling from the sky, and it ultimately destroyed his whole field. So now, when he was sad, he stood in the middle of the field, okay, and he said to his son, like, sons, a plague of locust. You know what a locust? It's an insect. You know, it comes and the locust insect used to destroy the field. You know, the ripe crop, ripe maize. They used to eat them all, and this type of insect can destroy the entire field. Okay, this kind of insect eats the plants, eats the crops. You know, it can destroy the entire field. So he is saying a plague of locust would have left more than this. The hail has left nothing. This year we will have no corn. That night was a sorrowful one. All our work for nothing. There's no one who can help us. We'll go hungry this year. So Lancho said that to his son, that you know, locust, you know, the insect which I talked about, the insect would have left some of the crop undisturbed. You know, like locust is such a kind of insect which destroyed every crop. Okay, it doesn't leave a single crop. But Lancho compared that this locust insect would have left some more than the hailstorm, but the hailstorm has destroyed everything more than the locust insect. Locust also have some left for Lencho, but hailstorm has destroyed Lencho's entire field. So that night was sorrowful one, and he told his sons that there will be no crop this year because it was destroyed. Yeah, and this year they will go hungry because they have no crop to sell. But in the hearts of all, we who lived in the solitary house in the middle of the valley, there was a single hope, help from God. Don't be so upset. Even though this seems like a total loss, remember, no one dies of hunger. That's why they say no one dies of hunger. Okay? Although the night, Lancho thought only of his one hope, the help of God, whose eyes has he had been constructed, see everything, even what is deep in one's conscience. So what happened? You know, there's every human being, when they face a problem or they face a situation where they are not out of it or they are helpless, we know always we keep a hope. You know, we hope for something good will happen. Okay, the time will pass. When there is something bad happening in your life, then we always have a hope inside that no, everything will be all right. So that's what happened with Lancho and his family, that in the heart they know that there is a hope, still a hope in that alone house, in that single house in the valley. So there is only a hope, which is help from God. Don't be so upset. What he said, that that no one will die of hunger. We will be passing this hunger, that like God will help us. They have kept a hope within them. Okay, so now at the middle of the night, all throughout the night, Lancho only thought of this one hope, that God will help on. It's only God who will help him out of it. It is only God who will now see what he can do. So he has believed that God will come and help him now from this destruction that he has faced. Now all the family will die of hunger, so God will not let it happen. So he has kept that hope. It conscience is, you know, our strong feeling, our inside feeling that like everything will be fine. That is the conscience, that God is there, everything will be fine. So Lancho was an ox of a man, working like an animal in the field, but still he knew how to write. The following Sunday at daybreak, he began to write a letter, which he himself would carry to town and place in the mail. It was nothing less than a letter to a God. So what happened? Lancho was a very hardworking man. So Lancho was an ox of a man. You know what? It means like he only worked in the field. Who used to work hard in the field, having cultivation, he's plowing. Yeah. He's a farmer, he's a hardworking farmer, but still he knows how to write, okay? So he wrote a letter. The following Sunday, he wrote a letter to God and he took the letter to the town, yeah, to mail it to God. So God, he wrote, if you don't help me, my family, and I will go hungry this year. So this is the letter which he wrote to God. So he wrote, if you don't help me, my family, and I will go hungry this year, I need 100 pesos in order to sow my field again and to live until the crops come because the hailstorm, dot, dot, dot. So he wrote the whole story to God. So God, you have to help me. You have to give me some money. So he's asking God. He's asking help from God of how much money? He's asking 100 pesos, okay? He's asking 100 pesos to help him to go through this year so that his family does not suffer hunger, okay? So that he can get the money from God, 100 pesos he can get from God, and he can sow his field again. He can give his, he can ripe his field again because the hailstorm has destroyed his field. Everything he has described to God. He wrote to God on the envelope, put the letter inside, and still troubled, went to town. So at the post office, he placed the stamp on the letter and dropped it in the mailbox. So he wrote, whenever we write a letter to someone, what do? We have to put the address to whom it is concerned, whom we have written, from whom it is going. Yeah. So on the envelope, he wrote that to God. Okay. He put the address to God and he wrote his name. Okay. Everything he put, and he put the stamp and he mailed in the town. He put in the mailbox. So one of the employees, who was a postman and also helped at the post office, went to his boss laughing heartily and showed him the letter to God. Never in his career a postman had he known at that address. Okay, so what happened? Whenever what happened whenever we mail a letter to someone? Okay, that letters are being taken out from the mailbox and had been collect like there are post office where like many people working in the post office. So every letter is seen, which address have to go, the postman have to go to which address to deliver the letter. So everything has been sorted in that way. So all the letters were out of the mailbox. The postmaster is looking after the letter, who have to send the deliver the letter. So at that moment, one of the employee in the post of one of the worker in the post office saw this letter of Lanzhou that is written to God. So he was laughing because who is going to write the letter to God? Because there is no specific God is a person who is going to receive the letter, right? So he was laughing why he has written this letter to God. So he was laughing and he has he took the letter to the postmaster, okay, laughing. So the postmaster, you know, like we get to know the postmaster now, who is like a fat, amiable fellow. So it's a fat, amiable fellow, you know, he's a fat and he's a happy fellow, and also broke out laughing. He also was also laughing, but almost immediately he turned serious and tapping the letter on his desk commented, "What faith? I wish I had the faith of the man who wrote this letter, starting off a correspondence with God." So the man, postmaster, he also started laughing with his worker, because seeing the letter, everyone will laugh that, like, who is going to write the letter to God? But after laughing, he suddenly got serious and he put the letter, he tapped, you know, he kept the letter on the desk and he said that, "What faith, you know, this kind of faith who have written a letter to God and expecting, having hope that God will give him a reply, okay? God will give me reply and whatever he asking for, God will send him through letter. So that kind of faith, I wish I had." The postmaster had told that, okay? So in order not to shake the writer's faith in God, the postmaster came up with an idea, answer the letter. But when he opened it, it was evident that to answer it, he needed something more than goodwill. So ink and paper, but he stuck to his resolution. He asked for money from his employees. He himself gave part of his salary and several friends of his were obliged to give something for an act of charity. Now what happened? So there is the hero, Lanzhou wrote the letter to God. Obviously, the postmaster cannot send the letter to God. So what happened? The postmaster decided, let's help this man. Let's not disturb. Let's not shake the writer's faith. You know, let's not give this. He doesn't want to break Lanzhou's faith. So what he did, he opened up the letter, he read the letter, yeah, and he thought of an idea that we should help this man, okay? So he asked his employees, the postmaster asked his help from the workers to give money to him. So he is starting to collect money. He asked, Lanzhou asked 100 pesos. So postmaster, however, he want to help this Lanzhou and doesn't want to break his trust of God. So he started to help Lanzhou and he was sharing his salary, half of his salary, and he was also asking help from his workers to provide money to Lanzhou so that he can send to Lanzhou. Okay, it's an act of charity. Act of charity is helping someone. Okay, it was impossible for him to gather together the 100 pesos, so he was able to send the farmer only a little more than half. He put the money in an envelope addressed to Lanzhou and wrote a letter containing only a single word, a signature God. Okay. So now what happened? He collected money from this worker. He helped. He asking help from his workers who is working in the office. The postmaster also shared half of his salary, but still he cannot collect 100 pesos. Okay. So whatever he could collect from his workers and from himself, he decided to send that to Lanzhou, and he sent that to Lanzhou in a letter, and he just wrote from God. Okay. The following Sunday, Lanzhou came a bit earlier than usual to ask if there was a letter for him. It was the postmaster himself who handed the letter to him, while the postmaster, experiencing the contentment of a man who has performed a good deed, looked on from his office. Lanzhou showed not the slightest surprise on seeing the money, such was his confidence, but he became angry when he counted the money. God could not have made a mistake, nor could he been denied Lanzhou what he had requested. So, now, as we know, that Lanzhou has asked 100 pesos from God. But what happened? Lanzhou went to the town and asked if there is some letter, okay, from himself. So the postmaster came to know this is the man who has sent letter to God. So the postmaster gave him the letter, which he only sent it which we only decided to help Lanzhou. He gave the letter to Lanzhou. But Lanzhou, what happened? He got a little angry because when he counted the money from the envelope, it was not 100 pesos. So he was angry that I have requested God for 100 pesos and God couldn't even send 100 pesos. He sent only half of the amount. Okay. So he was angry with God. So immediately Lanzhou went up to the window to ask for paper and ink. On the public writing table, he started to write. with much wrinkling of his eyebrow caused by the effort he had to make to express his ideas. When he finished, he went to the window to buy a stamp when he licked and then affixed to the envelope with a blow of his fist. Now what happened is Lencho was very angry, like, oh, how come God has sent me only this much amount when I have asked 100 pesos, how God has sent me only half. So he was very angry with God. So with what happened, let's go back. So what happened, Lencho immediately, he went to the window of the post office. He went to the window, he took a paper and ink and he started to write. Okay, he was very angry. So, you know, wrinkling of his brow means when we get angry, we keep our wrinkle our brow. Yeah, we cross our brow like that. We are very angry. Whenever you see a man's facial expression, we can understand that he's very angry. So Lencho, as he was wrinkling his brow and he was writing the letter expressing his ideas, I have asked you this much money and you have given me this money. Yeah, and he put the then and there, he post the letter there and he put the stamp and he delivered the letter to the post office. Okay, so you know, fist is, yeah, okay. The moment the letter fell into the mailbox, the postmaster went to open it. It said, okay, the moment when the moment when the letter got in the mailbox, the postmaster went. Okay, because postmaster know that he was the one who have sent money to Lencho, right? It was not God. So he immediately, when Lencho dropped the letter to mailbox, the postmaster went to open it, and he opened the letter and he read, God of the money that I asked for, only 70 pesos reached me. Of the 100, he only got 70 pesos from the postmaster. Okay, so send me the rest since I need it very much. Okay. Now he's okay. Send me the rest since I need it very much, but don't send it to me. Don't send it to me through the mail, because the police office employs a branch of crooks, Lencho. Okay. Now, as we know that God has not helped Lencho, it was the postmaster who has helped Lencho collecting 70 pesos from his 100 pesos he has sent to Lencho. But Lencho was so angry that he got only 70 pesos out of 100. He wrote the letter to God angrily, and he wrote there that, God, you have only sent me 70 pesos. Please send all the 100 pesos, because only 70 pesos have reached me, and send it to me through me, not through the mail. Okay, because we expected that the employees of the post office have made a huge loss. Like, he has expected that the employees have stole the money from Lencho. Okay. So students, you have understood the chapter, I hope. So it's a very simple story. So I'll give a short summary of the chapter now. So what you know, like, it's a there in the initial of the story, we get to see there is only a small house where in the top of a hill, and there the field is very much of cultivation. It's good for harvesting. Yeah. So there lived Lencho, who was expecting rain in the in his field. So it was hailstorm. So because of the hailstorm, because of this large stone falling from the sky, the all of the crop got destroyed. All the flowers, all of his crop which was being grown has got destroyed. So Lencho was very helpless, because his family would die of hunger now. So what he decided to have faith in God, and what he did, he decided to write a letter to God asking help of 100 pesos so that his family doesn't die of hunger and he could again show his field. So what he did, he wrote a letter to God and he posted in the mail, and where the employees of the post office got the letter and they all laughed at him in the beginning, but the postmaster decided to help him, because the postmaster did not want to break the trust of Lencho in God. Okay, so postmaster, from his salary and asking help from his co-workers, has collected 70 pesos and sent to Lencho the letter. Okay, with 70 pesos. Okay, so telling that it has been sent by God. Okay, God has given him the 70 pesos. He did not let Lencho know that it was them who helped him. So Lencho came to the post office and got this letter, and he was very angry seeing only 70 pesos sent by God, because he asked 100 pesos. So he was very angry and he immediately wrote letter there to God that he was angry and he wrote that, please, you have only sent me 70 pesos. As I asked for 100 pesos, you gave me 70. So please send me the full amount and don't send me through the mail. You know, don't send me through mailbox, because he Lancho has claimed to God that maybe God has sent me 100 pesos and maybe God has sent me 100 pesos, but the other money was being looted. Yeah, looted by this post office people. Okay, the one who has really helped him, the one who was behind this helping hand, he doubted. He doubted this post office persons that he must have, that the post office persons have taken Lancho's half money sent by God. Okay, he claimed that the post office people are a bunch of crooks, which means dishonest persons. So he directly told God that please don't send the money to the mail, because these mail people are looting me. So you please send me the money directly to me. Okay, that is what the story is. So we can say the story is highlighting greed of Lancho, that even if he is getting help of 70 pesos, he's not satisfied, he is a greed, he needs 100 pesos, and he's also not understanding the one who has helped him originally. He has denied the fact and he has claimed them to be dishonest. Okay, so the act of charity went in vain. Okay, this is all the whole story is about. So I would request you guys to please look after the chapter and just give a quick reading of the chapter so that you can get a better understanding of it. And regarding the notes, I will send you through me through mail or online, I'll send you. So please be ready with the unit test you're going to have it. So prepare the chapter properly and read through the notes and prepare yourself. Yeah, thank you.